What's up, nerds? Welcome back to another Photo Nerds University tutorial. My name is Adam, and today I'm going to show you how to get up and running in Luminar 2018 in just 10 minutes. That's it. If you don't have Luminar 2018 yet, no problem. Just go to nerd.link/Luminar2018 to download your copy today. It's just $69. And now, without further ado, let's jump into today's tutorial. Resources. This video is just meant to be a quick overview of Luminar 2018 and some of the things that it has to offer. But in the event that you find yourself confused and you need a few more resources, Skylum has got you covered. Right here on the home screen, you'll see some resources to the left. This will allow you to access things like videos, user guides. You can even download more presets and additional plugins that Skylar has to offer. And don't forget about the Photo Nerds University YouTube channel, as we'll have more videos coming to you each and every week. So be sure to subscribe for that. Importing. There are several ways that you can open up a photo inside of Luminar 2018. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you two ways. One, when you open the program right here, you'll see an open image button. Go ahead and click that. Go ahead, find your file, select it, and hit open. Two, when you open up Luminar 2018, head on up to your file menu, click on it, and choose open. Same thing, just search for a photo, select it, and hit open. Interface. The interface is super duper easy. We have this top bar here, and the first thing you see, starting from left to right, we have the ability to open another image from here, even batch process. We can zoom in or zoom out of a photo. We can even change some ratios and fit to screen. Next, we have some before and after preview buttons. We can see it as a quick view or a slider. We have an undo button and a history panel, which will keep track of all the edits that we're making along the way. And then we have quick access to the tools that we probably will use the most. Things like the crop tool or free transform tool, a clone stamp tool for removing stuff, and even an eraser tool, which will come in pretty handy for those mistakes we'll make along the way. And the last two buttons, we have our presets panel down at the bottom and our side panel over on the right, which is where all the magic is going to happen. This is where we can see things like our histogram, layers, and all the filters we're going to use to edit this photo. Last but not least, we have our menu bar up at the top. Editing. Ah, yes, editing, that thing we've all been waiting for. There's so many things we could talk about in this video just on editing, so I'm gonna try and keep this simple as possible. And most things will come down to these two buttons right here that we talked about. The first one being the presets panel, so let's start there. When we click this button at the bottom of the screen, you'll see all of the presets that we have here. And these presets are things that either came with the program, or presets that you'll make along the way, or maybe even presets that you'll export out from Lightroom. But luckily for you, Luminar comes packed loaded with lots of presets for you to use on your photos in case you lack creative vision or you just need a little helping hand to get you started. Click on the presets panel to toggle that switch on and off, and simply scroll through all of the presets that you might be interested in using. When you find one that tickles your fancy, just go ahead and click on that preset, and you'll get a visual representation of what that preset looks like and what it might do to your photograph. I'll say Dark Moon doesn't look half bad, but I'm gonna keep searching. That's pretty cool. You'll notice also we have an amount slider when you hover over the preset, and this will allow you to, right here, right from the preset, dial back the amount. So if you have a preset that maybe is too aggressive, you can just go ahead and dial that back. Once you find the amount that you love, that's it, you're done. Now, if you're someone like me and you wanna continue editing, this is where the side panel comes in handy. Everything that you see on the right is the side panel. Now, right now, because we started by choosing a preset, we've got all these little tabs that popped up showing us what this preset applied. So it used curves, it used a photo filter, color contrast, all to make changes to our photograph. The nice thing about it is the preset did all the work. You didn't have to do anything. But if there was something that you wanted to change, For example, you wanted to add a little bit more of this photo filter adjustment, you could just come in here and dial in whatever you wanted to. You've also got some other switches here, like a eyeball, which will allow you to toggle on and off just that particular panel. So if I wanted to see what this filter looked like without photo filter, I could just go ahead and toggle that on and off. But I think it looks pretty cool, so I'm gonna leave it. Another thing that you could do is brush in your adjustment. So if you wanted to be a little bit more specific about where your adjustment was gonna be applied, you could just hit this brush. And then this gives you some options. You can either brush the effect in wherever you like. So if I click on that feature and head on over to the photo and I begin brushing, you'll see that it's gonna allow me to brush wherever I want. So this allows you to be more specific about where and what that adjustment will look like. But I'm gonna just go ahead and undo that because I liked it everywhere. If you want to undo your adjustment, remember we have that undo button here up at the top. We could just click on that and it'll take us right back to where we were. Pretty convenient. But if presets are not enough for you, well, Luminar's got you covered. If you drag your eyeballs up to the histogram and scroll down with your eyeballs just a little bit, you'll see a blue add filters button. If you were to click that, you're gonna get access to a load more features that you have at your disposal. And the thing I love most about this whole entire section is how organized it is. You'll see categories like the essentials or issue fixers, things that maybe need to get fixed, like maybe you need to remove things or sharpen things. We've also got an entire creative section of things that you could do. You have a professional section, but if you're not a professional, don't be afraid to use some of these tools because, well, they're awesome. And last but not least, down at the bottom, we've got an entire utilities section, which allows you to do things like add adjustable gradient maps or color temperatures, play with exposures, highlights, shadows. And the way this works is you just find a filter that sounds good to you. I'm gonna scroll all the way up to the top and select the very first one under the Essentials panel called Accent AI Filter. And when you click on it, you'll notice how it adds this filter to the other filters that were included in that preset that we started with. And all we're gonna do is pull on this boost slider right here, and that's gonna increase some of the things that we might or might not want. Once we get it to that desired effect, we just simply stop. And if I click on and off the eyeball, I can see what this accented AI filter has done. Not too shabby. The nice thing about this is you can add as many filters as you desire. So between the presets and the filters, you could do a lot. But that's not all. We also have layers. So if you want to take this photo and manipulate it as you would in Photoshop, you could do that right here without going over to a separate program. We've got layer panels. We can merge layers. We can merge all layers. We can click on this little icon here. We can duplicate layers. I'm going to go ahead and do that. We can right click on layers where we get more information, things like blending mode and image map and masking. I'm gonna change the blend mode on here to overlay because that's gonna give me some crazy amount of contrast. And then I'm going to lower the opacity by clicking on this drop down and dragging it all the way down. That looks pretty good. And we have more of those eyeballs where we can turn on and off the adjustment to see what that's doing. Once you've added your filters and your presets, you've made your adjustments, you've played with layers, and you find yourself done with a photograph, now we're ready to show this to the world. Exporting. So from here, we're gonna export this file out. Head on up to the top right corner, click this little share button, and export to image. From here, we'll get an export dialog box that'll allow you to make whatever changes that you want. We can name the file, we can choose the location we want to put it. I'll put mine on the desktop. We can even choose to apply additional sharpening to a photograph. Why not? I'll add a medium amount. We can resize our image if we need to make it smaller for the internet. I'll go ahead and resize it the long edge to 1080 pixels. You can even change the color space between sRGB, which is fantastic for the internet, or Adobe RGB or Profoto RGB for printing. I'll just leave it at sRGB. You can change the format from a PNG to a TIFF to a Photoshop file, and you can decide what you want your quality amount to be. I will leave mine at high. Once you've dialed in all this stuff, all you gotta do is hit save. Luminar will do all the work, and if we look at our desktop, there it is. 0943-3-edit, JPEG, with all of the adjustments that I made inside of Luminar. Fantastic.